So finding these kind of things, for example, finding plane and quad panels is it's something which is often applied as a post-rationalization step. So if there's a free form which has been designed using NURBS and then you want to make planar panels from it, it can be a very tricky challenge because the way the grid is organized and the curvature of the surface all interact very closely, and it's not always possible, given an initial form, to get planar panels in the way that you want. So I've tried to come at it from the other side in a way and actually put those constraints in from the start. And then, because it's fast enough, you can just play with it and see what's possible, given those constraints are already in the system. And more recently, looking a bit at, in this case, developable scripts, because it's something I've been seeing a lot of, is the desire to make things out of sheet material. And actually, if we can, in this case, making all of those faces planar, and as we subdivide further, it gets closer to something which is continuous in one direction, and we can just unroll and then roll back up into a smoothly curved form. So for kind of where it's going now and the future of Kangaroo, one thing which has really grabbed my attention is with these techniques that I've shown so far, it's been the connectivity of the mesh. So which node connects to which node has been fixed from the start, and just the positions and distances have been relaxed. Whereas here you see new circles that are appearing as the shape is changing. So this is something which I think has a very broad range of applications. Extends the applicability of dynamic relaxation to a lot of different fields. Actually, this when I released this feature, again, it was a surprise to me. I didn't know anything about jewelry, but lots of jewelers started contacting me talking about placing state on surfaces. So I've really kind of followed the interests of the users and when people are going. And that's taken me on lots of very exciting journeys that I wouldn't have ever expected or imagined myself if I'd just been working on it in isolation. So I said it moved away a bit from actual simulation of physical materials, but this is something just in the last few months I think I've come to a bit more. And working with the engineers from Bath University to simulate material properties in a more rigorous way for volumes and for surfaces. So here what you're seeing is there's a tetrahedral mesh, there's volume elements which have Jones modulus and a Poisson's ratio, and the Poisson's ratio, the Jones modulus is set very low in this example, just so you can see it moving a bit more, but you can actually the idea is that to have known material properties would be much more useful in the process. So this comes back again to sheet material, and this ties in again with this concept of meshing. So in that case, the meshing is happening before the simulation. But the quality of the triangulation really has a huge effect on